Hello everyone, welcome to the session on cybersecurity. So in this session we are going to look at identity theft. So this is like a kind of risk which is associated with techniques like phishing, etc. So in techniques like phishing, they will get all the information they need from you, sensitive information like all your personal information as well as credit card details and the bank account details, etc. And using those information, they can commit various frauds like financial frauds, employment frauds, etc. So this thing is called identity theft. So you can see here, identity theft involves impersonation of a legitimate user to commit fraud. So how do they impersonate a legitimate user is by getting all the information associated with this user through techniques like phishing and other social engineering techniques. And what are the types of frauds that are committed with identity theft is credit card fraud, like buying things using other person's credit card, bank fraud, like opening accounts and taking loans by using other person's details, employment fraud, pretending to be another person and going for interviews, that is employment fraud, government fraud, that is posing as other people and receiving all the benefits and subsidies from the government, and of course applying for loans, loan fraud. Okay, so in this image you can see most common types of identity theft, and the majority of those is credit card fraud. Okay, so one more important thing here, PII, personally identifiable information. So how does the attacker or hacker get this PII list? Through phishing and other social engineering techniques. So what is personally identifiable information is set of information which can identify a person uniquely. Okay, so what does the PII include is it includes full name of the person, other number, that is a national identification number in India, or if you take other countries like US, there is SSN, social security number, the mobile number, driving license number, credit card number, digital identity, birth date, birthplace, as well as biometrics. Okay, so all these things are collectively called personal identifiable information. And we have other information which can be considered as PII, that is only first name or last name, age of the person, country, state or city of residence, gender, name of the school, college or workplace, job position, the salary the person gets, and the criminal record of the person. And now this information can be classified as, one category is non-classified information, that is the information that is publicly available, and even if the information is attained or used by someone, there is no harm. So what is this non-classified information is public information or personal information which can be shared in the public without any consequences, or routine business information and private information. And then we have another category called classified information. In this, subcategories are confidential information, secret information, and top secret information. So whenever top secret information is compromised, or someone gets access to this top secret information, so the risk is it causes catastrophic damage. So example, if someone gets a hold of a country's defense plans and defense details, that leads to catastrophic damage. Okay, so we have different types of identity theft. So we have financial identity theft, criminal identity theft, and we is posing as another person and doing all the things as that person. And we have business identity there, we have medical identity there, and we have synthetic identity there, and last one is state identity there. And what are the different techniques of identity theft is, so we have human based methods where no technology is needed, so we can directly access information from the public sources like Google, Facebook, Instagram, etc. And we have dumpster diving, which we discussed in social engineering techniques, and we have mail theft and rerouting. So this is not email, this is physical mail, okay, letters. And we have folder surfing, which is another technique we have seen in social engineering. False or disguised ATMs. And we have dishonest or mistreated employees who will give information of your targets. And there is fake telephone calls. And then we have technology based or computer based techniques like backup theft, unauthorized access to systems and databases. So the attacker uses various techniques like SQL injection, buffer overflow, etc. to get unauthorized access. And there is phishing through emails, mobile, etc. And there is farming, where we redirect the target to another website and ask for information. And we have normal URL redirectors and using fake hardware. Okay. And what are the various countermeasures we can take or follow to protect from identity theft or these things? So always monitor bank transactions in your account from time to time. Even though if you don't get any SMS, log into your bank account through internet banking or use the bank mobile app to check what are the transactions being performed. Install security software like antivirus. Always update your browsers. And always be cautious while opening emails. Store the sensitive data securely. And always shred documents instead of deleting them. So if you are deleting any sensitive document that contains personal information, don't just delete it. Always use a software called Shredder. Okay. So even if you completely delete the document from recycle bin, it is still stored on the hard disk. So use a software called Shredder, which will shred the documents instead of deleting them. Once you shred the documents, you can't retrieve them, even if you use backup software. So protect your personally identifiable information. Don't share it to anyone. Only share it with your friends and family. And stay alert to the latest scams. So that's it about identity theft.